Good morning.
As we rise up this morning, we welcome you to Unity of New Braunfels live stream. I'm Reverend Gary Cunye, assisted by the very beautiful Reverend Maggie Alderman. And we are Unity, and Unity is a spiritual community that fosters personal transformation for healing, for wholeness, and for an intimate connection with the divine. We do this through affirmative prayer and meditation that opens us to realize our oneness with God. Now we honor the light that lives in all religious and spiritual traditions, for that light shining through every stained glass window, through every mosque, dome, cathedral, chapel, or church tent is the very same light shining in us. And we call that light God. Now we know that what we experience is based on what we say, what we believe. And when we say what we believe with conviction, or with what I like to call gusto, it ignites a powerful force in the universe. So let's say this great truth with gusto together.
There is only one presence, one power.
Active in my life and in the universe, God the good, omnipotent. And so it is.
Amen.
And with that, we're ready for our gathering prayer, and our wonderful prayer chaplain on duty today, Steve Cleverly, is going to guide us. Good morning, Steve.
Good morning. And I don't know what it is, but every time I get the opportunity and the privilege to be prayer chaplain here, it's a beautiful day outside. Just wonderful. So let's enjoy it today. And let us take a couple of deep breaths, inhale, and enjoy that wonderful feeling. And hold it for a few seconds and slowly let it out. And move from your head space to your heart. And come together for the message that we are going to have today. Today is a very special day. You know, for the last 18 months, we have not necessarily had a lot of things to say were great. We've had some decisive politics, a decisive election, still going through that, some of that. The pandemic started and built. We had a lot of people in hospitals. Unfortunately, a lot of people dying, and now a lot of decisions on whether or not to vaccinate. But the last 18 months, has brought us also something very wonderful. And today is a culmination of that wonderful. 18 months ago, Maggie Alderman started with us as an intern. And we have all had the opportunity to watch her grow, to become the butterfly out of the cocoon. She's been a very special and important part in our spiritual life. And today is the last day that we will hear her speak. Well, maybe not, but for a while, the last day we will hear her speak at Unity of New Braunfels. But we are grateful. We are grateful for allowing us to be part of her life and spiritual growth and see her come full bloom into Reverend Maggie Alderman. And we wish her and know that all will be wonderful in her new adventure. And we thank you, God, for allowing us again to be part of her life. And we release this out into the universe, and we release her into her new congregation with our love and gratitude. And so it is. Amen.
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 Thank you, Steve. Well, it is.
I'm just going to cry through the whole service today.
It's going to be a Sunday of tears. And we love the first Sunday of the month because we honor some of those traditions that are happening maybe outside of our own cultural experience. And we always love to start with co-founder Charles Fillmore wrote a powerful book, The 12 Powers of Man, and he outlined these faculties, these powers that each of us are innately given. And February is the month of love. The color is pink. The disciple is John. The location is the back of the heart. I love that we can just, we're right here with our love. And a short definition of this is it's our universal unity, the great harmonizer and healer. It's powerful. And let's remember love as we go through February.
Absolutely. And on February 1st was National Freedom Day. This is the day that celebrates the signing of the 13th Amendment, abolishing slavery in 1865. And accordingly, being that this was National Freedom Day, we celebrate and honor Black History Month throughout the month of February.
Absolutely. And the Chinese New Year is February 12th. Now, this year is the year of the ox. Now, this is, well, Gong Hi Fat Choi, Happy Chinese New Year. This is celebrated by billions of people, and it starts, it's a 15-day celebration beginning with the second new moon following the winter solstice and ends on the full moon, which would be February 12th. So let's celebrate the year of the ox.
I love that. And on the 16th of February is Vasant Panchami, the Hindu festival that highlights the coming of spring. On this day, Hindus around the world worship Saravati Devi. Did I get that fine?
Yeah.
Okay, good enough. The goddess of wisdom, knowledge, music, art, and culture. I love that they're honoring the coming spring so early in February for us.
It's certainly coming for us. And February 17th, I can't believe it's already here.
I know.
But Ash Wednesday. Now, Ash Wednesday is the beginning of Lent, the Lenten period, the 40 days before Easter. And the ashes are a Christian symbol for penitence. Now, this day of Ash Wednesday is that beginning of Lent. The day just before this, Tuesday the 16th, is our Mardi Gras festivities. Like, get it all out that Tuesday before we begin Lent.
I love that. And Purim is from February 25th to 26th. This is a Jewish celebration that marks the time when the Jewish community living in Persia was saved from genocide. On Purim, the Jewish people offer charity and share food with one another, their friends and family within their communities.
It's beautiful. So let's remember these holidays as we go through, because it's one way we can connect with all peoples.
Mm-hmm.
Now, our wonderful media director, Owen Housen, has brought together a fabulous new way for us to experience our church service. Beginning next Sunday, Valentine's Day, you can sign in to a Zoom link that will be in the Zoom links, and you can watch the live stream as one of the windows in that Zoom link, and you can see anyone else who's attended, and then you can also talk in the chat and all that fun stuff. And then following the service, we can have fellowship. It's really a great idea. So one connection, just connect to the Zoom, and then you can meet with people ahead of time and through the service and afterwards. Now, this will be starting about 10:45 next Sunday. You can sign into that Zoom link and see who else shows up. It's going to be a wonderful way. There are other churches who are doing this, and we're going to give it a go. And then I think this is the way we'll continue until we can come back together. Now, you can still watch it on YouTube or on Facebook through our website, but this new idea of watching it through Zoom, you'll be able to see other members of the community. It's beautiful.
Beautiful way to stay connected. And it's time for nominations for our Board of Trustees. So if you're feeling the call to step into leadership, to serve this beautiful community in a higher way, in a stewardship way, or if you have questions about what serving on the board entails, we are open to taking your questions, and we want to hear that Spirit is nudging you forward to take that leadership position. So if you're interested or if you have questions, please email the church, and somebody will get back to you directly to share their knowledge and what is entailed to put yourself forward for being on the board.
Beautiful. And a new team, the Policies and Procedures team. Now, when I think about policies and procedures and bylaws, I have a light that comes on. I just love them. So if the idea of working on policies and procedures turns a light on in you, then come join us. There's going to be a small group of us to work through. We've got a wonderful template, the Unity Worldwide Ministries, fabulous, complete policies and procedures, and we'll go in and tweak them and make it just ours. It's really good. So if you want to join that team, or for your interest in being on the board, you can call the church office, 830-608-9515. And now, our congregation song. So if you feel like it where you are, because I know we love the Beatles, just sing out and enjoy Let It Be by John Lennon and Paul McCartney. This was recorded with the Unity Singers June 23rd, 2019.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, people living in the world agree. There will be an answer, let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they may see. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be. Is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine on till tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sounds of music. Mother Mary, come to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
Wow, music that touches the heart.
Mm-hmm.
And that's so special for this first Sunday in February and this month of love and Reverend Maggie's last Sunday with us. Now, our talk title is Looking for Love. And what we're talking about is that divine love. Now, it's really easy to love what we love. I love Reverend Maggie.
I love you too.
I love this community. Now that doesn't require a whole lot of looking. But when we're in pain, or when we're in chaos, or when we're in judgment, or when we're in self-hate, looking for love might be the best choice we can make. What do you think?
It's true. I think that it's the inside job we've talked about, and the ability to condition our thoughts, condition our expectations, and build a strength in love that allows us to see love in all things, in all manners of speaking, in all relationships, in all exchanges that we have throughout the course of our days. And when we're strong and we are clear, then we are more prone to see love when we look for it in our existence. So we wanted to start today with Nikki Banis, who I found her blog when we were getting ready. She's just got a beautiful plethora of writings, and this fit to open our service. She says, when you fill your mind with thoughts of kindness, love, faith, hope, and joy, your reality will become all of these things. You will start to see kindness in the world. You will start to feel love as you go about your day. You will notice more of the little joys of life. You've tried listening to your fears and doubts, and they've never brought you happiness. It's time to start choosing love. It's time to start choosing faith. So what a beautiful segue to go from January, where we were steeped in faith and really looking at how our roots and wings of faith carry us through transitions of becoming who and what we are. and now stepping into the power of love, where we're spotlighting that faculty within our beingness and allowing it to become activated with true deliberate intention. And isn't it true that when we are feeling good, when we are prayed up, when we're feeling strong in our spiritual position in life, that we start to see more that we resonate with? And if we are being in love, then we look for love and find it with ease and with grace as we go along through transitions, through exchanges with neighbors, or whatever comes our way. And it's a perfect time to recognize that this is the season of nonviolence. What better way to not be violent in our thoughts or our actions than to be in love? What do you think?
Well, I think this is powerful. And when we can know that I like to call God love. Mm-hmm. That's one of the words I use for God, is love. Because love embraces all things. It's that universal unity. And if we, as unity peoples, we claim that we are one, mm-hmm. that we're one with each other, we're one with God. Now, we experience that oneness when we're centered in our heart space, but we can also see how there's discord and how we're not in oneness, in unity. And looking for love is when we're in that, I can't see it, mm-hmm. all we need do is find the love, and then the love dispels everything else. Mm-hmm. It's powerful. Now, our co-founder, Charles Fillmore, wrote about this and says, it is the law of spirit that we must be that which we would draw to us. We would draw to us love. We must be love, be loving and kind. If we would have peace and harmony in our environment, we must establish it within ourselves. I think it's virtually every Sunday we talk about some aspect of how this is something we need to do for ourselves, by ourselves. No one else can do this. Mm-hmm. But if God is love, then the law of love works in the universe that when we're loving, we experience love. When we are peaceful, when we're finding connections of harmony and balance, we're balanced, we're harmonized. Now, this is all well and good when everything's just peachy keen.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are times in this acknowledgement of Reverend Maggie Aldman taking the senior position at Christ Church Unity in Orlando where I felt sadness. And then I felt more sad and more depressed and unhappy. And then I go deeper in my heart. Why would I feel unhappy for seeing Maggie go where her dreams and visions are for herself, to manifest that position? And she's so ready to do that. And from that perspective, I've looked for the love, and I celebrate that change. Celebrate that you're leaving. And my human self can also get caught up in the sadness and the grief. And I'm smiling about it now, but I'm smiling because I don't want to turn into a bundle of tears. And I've already cried about this quite a bit.
I'm just crying my way through it now. Oh, Charles Fillmore has a way of reminding us that it is always our journey to become more of a self-actualized human being. He honors and respects that we are spiritual in nature, but that we were given this vehicle to navigate through a lifespan. And I have attracted so much crap in my life. I have lived through being bullied in school, being broke, not living where I want to be in a job that I hated, just to survive. And when we come into the spirit and the faculty of love, we can gain the responsibility that we have to organize our infrastructure, the inwardness, so that we are clearing the junk, so that we are adopting a spirit of gratitude, so that we are taking care of ourselves and loving into existence that which we are. And as a byproduct of that, I believe, and I think Charles would agree, is that if we are that, then we resonate with those people along that same frequency. And I found that here. I found that the minute I met you, and I grew into a higher vibration. That vibration, this community, along with my education and countless angels on this planet who have loved me into existence, have helped been my co-creators, my co-pilots in manifesting my dream. That's not to say that it's not painful, but I'm going filled up completely in love and feel like I'm being carried on the wings of love. So our next person that we've got some wisdom to share for you is Gabrielle Bernstein. And we discovered her looking for support for our talk this week as well. And she's an American author, tons of great wisdom out there, and a New Thought author, which I think I'm going to have to look for some of her books. She says that the people who inspire me most are those willing to see the world from a loving perspective, people who perceive obstacles as opportunities and problems as spiritual assignments, people who choose love. This reminds me of one of the most impactful people in my life. And there's a picture on my Facebook page of having dinner with my friend Jan, who I think probably has the same frequency that Jesus did, where he could heal you by just being in the vicinity of your presence, right? Jan has that same balm about her. So when I am finding my thoughts pointing at other people, if I don't like that you park in front of my house, neighbor friend of mine who keeps me from being able to block back straight out of my driveway, if I am looking at my bank account and it's feeling like, where the heck did all my money go? Or if I'm just feeling a strife and a struggle and my thoughts are going along to feed me like, oh yeah, Maggie, you have every right to feel like that. And darn those neighbors. And well, you shouldn't have spent that money. I remember Jan. And I remember all of the people like Jan. You're one of those people, Reverend Gary, who always shift things to look through the lens of love, to choose to see God at work for my highest good in all manners of speaking. And then I think about how my energy must feel when I'm in the dumps. And I'm looking around, and of course I'm lonely. No one wants to be around that energy. No one wants to resonate and commiserate endlessly for a long period of time. I choose love. I choose to see love and look for love by elevating my internal vibration and strengthening my connection to each one of you as the face of God, to God in my individual and private relationship as I see it any given day, and not to be pulled off center and into a negative train of thoughts, lowering my consciousness and my vibration so that I am capable of seeing the good and making those connections and knowing that we are abundantly blessed in all manners of our lives. What do you think?
I think it's so true. And one of my heroines, the person I look to for that dedication of purpose and seeing the world from a loving perspective, is Mother Teresa, who I had the honor to interview in 1989. And from that experience, she spoke quite frankly about her journey, about her vision and her passion of seeing Jesus in everyone and attending to the poorest of poor, looking for love and being love. And she said to us, we're praying night and day to find medicines for our people. This is a woman who never said no to being love. And realize that if someone's low, we have the capacity to love them up.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, I can do that myself because there's times in our lives where we are low, where there's a diagnosis or relationship problems or any of the situations of life that have us feel a lot of feelings, and how wonderful it is that we have pastoral care, prayer chaplains that are committed to call and reach out to us. This is that loving perspective that takes opportunities of pain and anguish and bring out the wisdom. A mercy dying. In Mother Teresa's case, scooping up people off of the street near death and giving them a merciful death. Or how we can respond by a call or an answer. Looking for love is a great way to find what we can do next, to be a servant of love. Another quote from Gabrielle Bernstein, we are not responsible for what our eyes are seeing. We are responsible for how we perceive what we are seeing. I love that because it takes, we're not responsible for anything out there. All of that stuff that we're seeing is not our responsibility. But as soon as we've received it, what are we doing with it?
Mm-hmm.
How are we handling it? And from that perspective, that's where we take action. And if we're in trouble, we can reach out for help. And believe me, there are times when I feel deep sadness, deep anger, deep hurt. Just last week, I experienced the magnitude of those feelings.
Mm-hmm.
And then, by simply requesting help, I'm able to see, wow, I'm capable of healing old wounds.
Mm-hmm.
I'm capable to see things rightly and to take action so that that particular thing doesn't happen again. I love that we learn and we learn by taking responsibility, mm-hmm. by looking for love.
Mm-hmm. And it takes practice. I remember the first time that I had the light bulb moment of love. And as I said just a few minutes ago, I was bullied. I was bullied in the worst sense of the word from first grade until I finally took charge and said, I'm not going to be around these people anymore. I'm not going to go to this school, and I don't want to be a part of this clique that clearly doesn't want me here. And it was painful for 8 years of those foundational developmental stages in our lives where I didn't belong. And I was set out to be embarrassed and set apart from. And it wasn't until maybe 20 years later where I had to break the story of those mean girls, if they'd only known how awesome I was going to turn out, and let that story go, the perception had to shift. And I started in gratitude. Thank you for not allowing me to be a part of that low frequency. Thank you for showing me early on in my life that I will always be apart from, because I have a divine appointment. And it's really hard to tell an 8-year-old or a 12-year-old, you're gathering all these feelings because it's going to serve you in your higher calling and your life's purpose. And I'm reminded of the story of Joseph and the coat of many colors and the multitude of situations he was put in because he had a divine appointment. Because he inevitably, years into his life's journey, was going to save Egypt from famine. And I can resonate with that. I have to lean into love and remember that huge lesson that I got the first time I was able to do it for myself. And when you can do that in the big things in our lives, then the little things come a little easier. And how I did it eventually was that I wrote it down. I wrote down what was happening in my narrative that my mind was telling me. And then I thought, what if this is for me? So I had to go deliberately into an exercise on paper of acknowledging my feelings and seeing how these people were catalysts to move me forward and develop a loving appreciation for their role in my life and helping me know that I was going to be something that wasn't contained in El Paso, Texas, by the mean girls. So I invite you to think about that activity as you come across big things and little things, and you're looking deliberately for love. And so to wrap up our talk this week, we've got another quote from Charles Fillmore, our co-founder, where he says that love is the most obedient thing in the universe. It is also the greatest worker and will accomplish more for our happiness than any other faculties combined. And we've got 11 other amazing faculties, and we can partner love with any of those. But love is the great harmonizer that, as a standalone power, allows us to see and be and act in our highest good. As a standalone power, it also allows us to receive our feelings of love that get showered upon us in those daily interactions from our families and our friends. And I'll confess that sometimes I have a hard time accepting love. But when we're ready, we find those right people who have that same Jesus frequency and have the power to just spill love out of their cup and act like a salve for whatever wounds we're working through at that moment. And we are living in a time when the universe is saying, raise up, wake up, and be in love, because we can't leave anybody behind. We can't leave people in a lower frequency and do the work that we agreed to do on our collective soul's journey, to be moving forward, to be in love and accept and see the truth of our oneness, no matter your color, your creed, your religious denomination, or how much money you've got sitting in the bank account, is to just look for love. Look for God in the face of our neighbors and in every single situation that we come across. Because I feel like when we can do that, we're taking care of ourselves and we are taking steps to be that Jesus presence, that Christ presence for others in their healing journey as we go home together. What do you think?
Well, I think it is a choice. I remember in high school, I was in a semantics class, and we were talking about assumptions and expectations, and we were having a conversation about how we perceive others feel about us. And I got in touch with, I believed everyone thought I was a frog, and I believed I was a frog too. And I first asked the question, if I didn't identify myself as a frog and love myself for just me, that would be one person for me. And I began that practice, and lo, my world changed. It opened up a whole new level of being. Because all we need do is turn on love, and love works through everything. It is a superpower tool that will transform our lives. The next year, I was the lead in the high school musical and voted the most popular person in the school. And in my junior year, when I was a frog, no one even knew I existed because I perceived myself as small. And there's nothing small about divine love. And when we choose to look for love, we'll find it in all the right places. Let's take this into meditation. And as we do this, now, let's allow the Unity Singers to help bring us there with this Be Still and Know by Ron Bretsky, recorded on January 19th, 2020.
Om
what you sow is what you reap. Be here now. The one is known where life's fountain always flowing. Be still. Be still. Be still.
Back, the center of our being, where we connect with love. And as you breathe easy, and as that song said, be still and know. Focus within your heart space and connect with the divine. And here I'd like you to bring the image of Reverend Maggie Alderman into your heart space, surrounded, comfortable, in white light, golden light, pink light. And we bask in our appreciation and gratitude of what we see in this brilliant minister. We also acknowledge and know that as we go forward, she's part of our family. And so see that connection between Maggie and yourself, your best friends in this community, the last person you saw in our community at HEB or Costco, the people you used to sit with at the 9:15 service or the 11 o'clock service, with the people that you love to connect with in your spirit group or in classes. This is how we look for love in our connection, in our community, facing any challenges and aware that we have all the power we need to find love through any situation. And so with our heart full of connections and threads with our connections in the community, our deep love for Reverend Maggie, and for what we are as a community in what we do in the world, this is why this is so valuable to us. It fills us. It opens us. It teaches us. It renews us. And at any moment, we can turn within and connect with our heart and connect with someone we love deeply. And that person might be loving ourselves. Maybe loving on ourselves in a way we never have before. Because we love ourselves for not being perfect, for being human. That we remain teachable. I can learn to say I'm sorry. And I can learn to forgive. I can learn to hope and have praise. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this opportunity to be reminded that love is right here for the taking, for the receiving, for the acknowledgement. And we send Reverend Magrie on her way because we see her bringing her light, her love to her new church community. And we're no less for it because she carries our love with her. This is how God works through us. Loving the world through our heart, through our hands, through our feet, through our mouths. So as we begin to bring this meditation to a close, you might sense in your heart that you want to reach out and talk to someone you haven't talked to for a while and share that love. You might write a card or a letter and express that love. Because whenever we seek to look for love, we'll find love. What a blessing this is. And we allow that blessing to infuse everything we are and who we're with. And if that seems too big, then bring it home to right now. I love this moment. I love being alive. I love Reverend Magrie. I love this community. I love you, God. Thank you. Thank you, God. And let's take this into the silence. Saying yes to love allows us the opportunity to experience love. And we're so grateful for God's loving care flowing through us in this way. And so as we bring our attention back to wherever we are, we might wiggle our fingers, wiggle our toes, roll our head, and when we're ready, we open our eyes, and here we see an affirmation that goes with today's talk. And we say it together. I believe in the power of divine love. And so it is. This is the first Sunday of the month, so we do a separate collection for our prudent reserve. It's also this time in the service when we can offer a prayer, our gratitude. We can offer our love offering or donation. Set the intention of what you're going to give to in your love offering and into your prudent reserve as a separate collection. And place that on the altar of your heart as we say this beautiful affirmation together. Divine love now fulfills my every good desire. I rejoice in my happy, prosperous life right now. And so it is.
And as you may be giving your tithes and love offerings together, utilizing our donation button on the website or our text-to-tithe feature, whatever your intention and your vision and what is in your heart, we want to bless that and express the gratitude for what we know is and what we know will be, affirming that we are doing God's good work here. We are abundantly blessed, and we are living out our vision and our mission to elevate the consciousness of this community and carry that out into the world. We accept that as truth. We accept that as our personal truth and see it prosper and grow and multiply within this community. And so we say thank you, God, for the work done in advance. And we open ourselves up to receiving our highest good. And so it is. Amen.
Amen. Our prayer chaplain on duty is Steve Cleverly. And you have the opportunity to call the church office between 12 and 12:30, 830-608-9515, and have a one-on-one prayer experience with him. Sometimes we believe our light is dim, but our prayer chaplains hold the high watch, and they'll shine that light in that prayer consciousness. And prayers are always kept confidential. You can also reach out to our prayer chaplains by email, prayerchaplainsnb@gmail.com. Unity was founded in prayer, and we know that prayer works.
And starting today is A Path Home. This is our new member class that's going to be facilitated by Linda Gillespie, assistant minister and LUT for our community. This class is for anybody who wants to know more about Unity, the foundations of, or what's directly being experienced and taught within our community. So this is starting today, February 7th at 2:30. You should have the link for the Zoom session in your email. And if you don't, you can contact us at the church and we'll be sure to get that resent to you.
Beautiful. And now, the music of the Unity Singers. This is Shake It Up by Ron Bretzky, recorded January 26, 2020.
Always knew someday I'd find my way. Always knew sometime I'd find the one. I've been up and down in every way. I was certain you'd come along. Now take my heart, take my soul, wrap it up bit warm. I'll give you all I've got to give. Let's shake up this world and live. Be it mine to see the light. Be it mine to see the light. Be it mine to see the light. The mighty river flows down to the sea. Fed by the waters falling from the sky. Your love keeps me strong and sets me free. A love that flows through good and troubled times. So when the harvest comes to reap, will I have sown a gracious seed? I give this world and live. Let's shake up this world and live.
We have a new spirit group that's going to start on Thursday, February 25th. Now, this is a wonderful book, A New Earth by Eckhart Tolle. This is called Living an Awakened Life. So it'll be 12 weeks starting on February 25th from 5:30 to 7:30. Now, this is with our own Kathy Overkamp, licensed union teacher, assisted by Cheryl Godfrey and September Baker McLeod. What a wonderful opportunity to come together and connect.
Mm-hmm. And now let us join our voices in saying the prayer for protection by James Dillett Freeman. Together.
The light of God surrounds us.
The love of God enfolds us.
The power of God protects us.
The presence of God watches over us.
Wherever we are, God is. And all is well.
And with that, thank you for joining us here at Unity of New Braunfels. You can go to our website and find out all the things that we have come up. And sign up for our e-newsletter if you're not getting that, because you'll get a weekly update and also a separate email with all our Zoom links so that you won't miss out on any opportunity. And with that, with many blessings and with deep love for Reverend Maggie, we close with
Namaste. Namaste.